bears denied as poor weather strikes Edgbaston. With Oliver Hannon-Dalby taking all five of the Derbyshire wickets on day three, only bad weather prevented the Bears from driving home their authority. The day brought to a close early with the score 71 for 5, Derbyshire's lead just 39. Derbyshire started the day with renewed optimism, the Bears' authority evaporated, and the visitors found a foothold, largely thanks to Matt Critchley. He and Harvey Hosein negotiated the score past 100, the morning good to the visitors. It got better. Critchley's important knock brought with it a half century. Hannon-Dalby punished to reach the landmark figure. This was a crucial partnership for Derbyshire. The recovery was on, and the lead was almost 120 when they passed 150 runs. Critchley now searching for triple figures. By the time they'd reached the lunch interval, Critchley was on 75, and Derbyshire had enjoyed the session. The score 159 for 5, the lead 127. Norwell found a way to remove the set Derbyshire man soon after the resumption. His pad struck, and Critchley was out for 83. But then it was Hossein's turn to reach 50. His half-century came from 103 balls. Rhodes dispensed of his partner, Hudson Prentice nicking behind for 21 as the home side rediscovered their momentum. That wicket was sufficient to spark a collapse. Cohen followed, removed by Miles for 3. The same combination had Aitchison out, Haynes' catch seeing him depart. Norwell wrapped it up. Connor's only able to add 4 to the score, and Derbyshire all out for 244. The target for the Bears, a tantalising 213 at tee. The Warwickshire reply lasted all of 4 overs. Snow drifted over Edgbaston, it turned to rain, and they'd be forced from the field of play. That's where they remained, the match drawn. Derbyshire had dug deep to fight their way back into the game. Decent knocks from their men Lauder denied Warwickshire the momentum they craved after Hannon-Dalby's explosive opening salvo. The hosts turned visitors next time out, travelling across the Midlands to Trent Bridge, while Derbyshire returned to the Incora County Ground, where they will host Worcestershire.